is what happens if the elevator is out and then there's some mass evacuation. Well, I mean, that's what the first responders are for. Public safety would respond first. We immediately look for the fire department because they're better equipped for carrying folks out and things like that. If you have a personal emergency that's not connected to a mass evacuation, when you have a 911 operator on the phone, please tell them that you have mobility issues and be specific. And it could involve dispatching a special ambulance. But it's all up to the first responders to help get folks out. There was a question about how do I help my elderly neighbor? Well, check in on them. And if there's an emergency, check in on them more. You may be able to pick up some milk or bread for them, or help them in any way. We have a large senior population on the island, and the public safety department takes a special interest in helping our seniors. And fortunately, they're right next door to us. A lot, not all of them, but a lot of them are in 546. So it's every class that we mentioned in all of our advisories when we have emergencies. Please look in on your own things.
And speaking about people with special medical needs, we have something called the Advanced Warning System, AWS. What we do is with an impending emergency, we'll send out a message to anybody who's a caregiver, some of the food delivery services, people who have home attendants that go out and provide care for people. We'll send a message out to them, informing them of what the situation is, so they get better care for the person that they're taking care of. Whether to deliver extra meals, maybe evacuate them, maybe have extra medication in the house. So we have a protocol for that also. I got a question here about life vests. Hopefully it doesn't come to that degree, but I don't think the island's going to get that. That's full of water, but if people are going to evacuate you using boats, we would definitely have life vests. You know, that would be clearly a protocol. We would never put anybody on a vessel if they didn't have enough life vests for everybody. But as far as having one under your bed, on the island, I don't think that's necessary. All right. Documents, of course, a lot of people, I got a lot of questions about documents, they didn't have any open. You should have copies of your important papers. You know, I think important papers should be in the deposit box or a box that's fireproof. But in that go bag, you may want to have a copy of your passport, your birth certificate, whatever you feel is an important piece of paper. That's a very good question. But again, I don't think the original should go to that bag.
If you have a question, hold up your card. This is your last call for questions. I'm not seeing any. I see one hand. But as our last question, we'll continue with the remaining part.
I have a question here on the bridge malfunction from the other day. We're going to do an end of action on that. We're going to take a look at that and see exactly what it was about, what caused it, and what we can do better. We had a plan. We were able to put in place that some work needed to evacuate. We were able to make it off the island. We put that in place. But every time we have an event, we do an end of action report. So we're going to do that. We're going to sit down. We're going to see what caused it. How we responded and how we can do it better. And just so you know, we talked about that issue with 911. When that was brought to our attention by Jack and Susan, we coordinated that response pretty quick. Ben Krakow right there. He's the fellow, he's my expert on just about everything, Ben. And we charged him with putting this together, getting the right people in the room, and solving that problem. We knew that when you folks called 911, you were very frustrated a lot of times. But you would get, what's the grocery? And we know the number of grocery. The 911 operators really didn't understand it. You know, they, I doubt too many live on the island, so they don't understand the concept of a grocery. So we worked with them, we coordinated that meeting, we sat with FDA and PD, and we solved that problem a lot quicker, I think, than I thought we would solve. It worked out pretty quick. So I, my commitment to you is we're going to talk about your evacuation plan, we'll talk about the bridge, and we'll get some answers to the council board.
About 5 minutes after the bridge locked up, Susan and myself went up to the bridge where it was stuck. Kevin Brown, our new deputy director, happened to have been on the island side of the bridge. There was a lot going on here. We had ambulances and fire apparatus already staged on the island due to the UN General Assembly, with the potential for the bridge to go up and down several times a day. The bridge came down, the platform came down, it didn't land flush, and an attempt to engage it, basically, the motor broke. So we had to go with it. I was on the bridge for about 5 minutes. I didn't even have to call OEM. Ben Krakow called me, and we went over, he put some things in place before he even called, and then we responded to a few things. If somebody needed to be removed from the island, we had two plans in place, actually, depending on the condition of the individual. We had apparatus and ambulances on the queen side of the bridge, and we would have been able to get folks to the queen side and do a handover. The other piece, which sometimes, it may not make sense to you, but our tram is about 6 minutes into Manhattan. We had also a plan where emergency responders could have transported a hurt or sick individual on the tram, and you think about it, you're on the other side of the tram, and you're in some of the best hospitals in New York. So I'm confident that we'll be able to respond to any emergency that comes forward. It's just that there are so many eventualities, there can't be one evacuation plan. All the dynamics on these things changed after 9/11.
So there's one last question. We've covered seniors, we've covered disability, we have not covered children. Do schools have the same emergency plan? What are some important points to discuss with children? I do know we have a bunch of them here. And we actually have a great comment coming back from the Avengers. That was actually just a video for the kids, or the kids at heart in the room. Great comment from the tree. But what about kids?
Well, we and we all want kids are very, very important. The comic book character that the council has put out.
It's a character that we invented, basically. It's a member of our staff, and she's a ready girl. She's a costume character. Marvel Comics actually did a comic book about her, about how to get ready in an emergency. We have her go out to school to talk to kids about how to be ready. We think if we start them as early as possible, they'll take that message with them going through life. If anybody here was a Boy Scout, or a Girl Scout, or a Cub Scout, or a Brownie, I know I was a Boy Scout. What I learned in the Boy Scouts, I still use that 60 years later. I still use it. That's a good foundation. But we're trying to get those kids as involved as quickly as possible on how to have a plan, how to be ready mentally, what to do if something were to happen. And again, our shelters, we know that there are a lot of needs, a lot of special needs, children need one of them. All our shelters have the capacity to deal with people of all ages. We have cots. We have cots for children. We have cots for adults. We have cots for people with special needs. So when we supply a shelter, children are very much in our minds. We're ready to deal with that. So we are all closed up with our Q&A. I just want to thank everyone who participated, especially you for joining us this evening, because you are ready. We will be relying on you to work with our CERT team, work with your neighbors, and be ready. So I just want to thank Office of Emergency Management. We give them a quick round.
Thank you. has your designation for, just like we do on a plane. We're going to end it back. I'm going to call you by number. So this is for people who have RSVPs first. There is a go bag for everyone. So if you have an RSVP, if you have it, so we're going to call you by number. So we want to do an orderly line. So if your number is 10, please join us in the back. We will call the next 10 soon.
Thank you. I come up for me?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Did you hear me?